Let me start though by taking a sip of coffee. And it's probably going to be a longer video, so brace yourself. Good morning, my lovelies, and welcome to my channel. Today I am going to talk about something that you have been pestering me about for years, and that is how I shave my head, and well, not specifically how, but why I shave my head. And I have some new things to talk about because I have a bunch of stuff from Rare Beauty here, and we're going to play with this one, the Lethal Is Dead palette. Yes. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent, and I am here to help you feel fabulous in your 40s. Why am I qualified for that? Well, basically because I am in my 40s and I'm fabulous. Yes, so if you want to learn how to apply things on, yes, stuff that is hanging, that is not as up and perky as it used to be. If you want to know how to combine unusual color combinations, or maybe you are a light olive like me and you are stumped at, well, the products that you need, basically, then this is the channel for you. Make sure to subscribe and become part of my nestlings, because we are just having so much fun here on the internet. Yes, okay, I need to... It's weird weather here right now. It's warm, but it's also humid, and it's... If you are new, I will live at the Dutch coast. So, yeah, I don't know what's happening with our summer, but it's basically non-existent right now. Let me start by showing you kind of what I got. So I got from Rare Beauty, I got one of the primers. This is the illuminating one, if I am not mistaken. Then I got a foundation in the shade 230 Neutral, which is their light medium neutral olive. So I don't really know why there's an N, but that's the shade name. Yes, I also got the concealer in the same color, which, as you can tell, there is a tone difference. I wish this was not frosted glass, but that's okay. Is it glass? Actually, I think it's plastic. I also got one of the blushes. I don't know. It's this one in the shade Joy. And looking at the swatches, it's kind of like a luminous blush. And I was like, I don't have that yet. Then I got, as a gift with purchase, I got a mini lip gloss. It's very, very tiny. Let me get it out. So here it is. And I think everyone got the same mini, because I watched Angelica's vlog. If you don't know, Angelica Nikvis also has a vlog channel. And she mentioned that she got the exact same shade. So it's basically universal. But yeah, I have that one as well. And then obviously the Lethal Is Dead palette. And then for the rest, I have already... pulled my kind of my favorite bronzer of right now, which is the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil. And then for the rest, I don't know. We shall see. We shall see. Yes, let me start by priming my face. Oh, this is nice. I don't know if you can see it, but it is indeed a tiny bit luminous. So let's see. Now, usually I have a problem with foundation gripping here, especially in summer. So what I want in a primer in summer is something that kind of looks in a little bit of hydration, but also gives me a little bit of grip. Feels nice. Okay, okay then. That's good. What I usually do then is my brows. So let me kind of quickly do that, or at least put a little bit of stuff in the brows. And what I'm using is my Pink Honey Original Super Hold. Then I usually kind of let that set a little bit before I go any further. I'm quite interested in the... I don't know if this is normal. It reminds me of a spray can. Yeah, it has a doe foot, because I already checked. And it has a doe foot. It is kind of... I feel almost... I think it's a tad too dark, though. But we shall see. And it is a little bit of a... I think it's a thinner formula, because this is kind of like a skin tint. No, it's not really, but it's very thin. That's how I feel, at least. And I don't really know... Usually, I put stuff on a sheet and then I pick it up with a sponge. That's how I am. That's how I usually do my makeup. I think it's too dark, yeah. But maybe we can kind of lighten it up a little bit with the concealer, because that's a little bit... They have a shade lighter in the olive spectrum, but that is then the light. So I am afraid that that one will be too light. And I was kind of hoping... Why do I have a little friend here? I don't know. I was kind of hoping that I did not have to mix this too much, but... It is what it is. What can you do about it? So yeah, shaving my head. I have gotten so many questions over the years why I did that, and I kind of spoke about it in videos here and there, but and I was like, I will just do a dedicated video on it, because it's easier, because then I can just refer people back to the video, you know. It is too dark. I can see that it is too dark, but not by much. So I think that if I were to be more in summer, like we should be, it would have been a good match for me. So I think this is a very nice summer color. And if I like it, I will probably want the lighter shade as well for winter. So let's kind of do a little bit here. A little bit extra. I know I have concealer. That's okay. So... I will dig through the archives for pictures of me pre-shaved. Basically, I have always been messing with my hair. Also, in case you don't know, especially before I started my YouTube channel, I was pretty self-conscious. And a lot of the time when I don't know, went into town, people were looking at me, and I always thought that there was something wrong. You know, it was just my mindset then. It was not really, unless I felt particularly good about myself, but then still, I don't know, I just was very, very self-conscious. And as I've said, I've always messed with my hair. I have gone from short to long, because I also used to put in my own extensions. So I would go from basically short hair to very, very long hair, you know, yay long, and vice versa. I would go from dark to blonde, but usually blonde was not something that I really liked on myself. So I went back very, very quickly, and then I went to black and to red and everything in between. So yeah, and my hair type is very fine of structure as well. And it's one side kind of hangs like, and the other side is like, whew, we are still up and perky. It's my hair was in an identity crisis. Like me, basically. Let me also try the concealer while I'm chatting. I really like how it feels, actually. I hope I can kind of keep my train of thought. Ooh, it's a very big, this is not even a doe foot, this is an elephant foot. Let's put it a little bit here. Oh, this feels nice. And a little bit there. This is very fancy for me, not gonna lie. Do I need to lighten it up? I don't feel like I very much need to lighten it up, but we'll lighten it up a little bit. So, yeah, I was always doing stuff with my hair, and because that's what people see. And especially before my YouTube channel, I was not really into makeup. So that was basically, yeah, what I did, you know, my hair. And then there was a period of time, well, basically Vikings came on TV, which for me was almost a godsend, because I was very much into making Viking-esque that period clothing for when I would go to festivals and such. But there was not really much known then. Is Vikings historically accurate? Not really, but also it kind of is. It gives you a little bit of inspiration, you know. So I was very happy when that show came on TV, and it gave me just a lot of inspiration. Now you can obviously see my basically, I don't know, Viking, let's call it Viking, because I can say a lot of things about the word Viking, but everyone knows what I mean, right? So let's go with that. So that was also my inspiration. That was kind of, it wasn't my identity or anything, but it was just something that I felt very, very comfortable in. I wanted to embrace my inner warrior, and Yeah, I wanted to do something again with my hair. Now, what you also need to know is that I have had it happen that I was like, I've always cut my own hair for years because every time I went to the hairdresser, I ended up cutting my own hair anyway. And I actually had the shortest that I had my hair back then, which kind of was a boo-boo, but it turned out okay, was basically this. So, I don't know, a thumb, around 2 centimeters, I think. I think that was the shortest that I had it cut. And then, was that the shortest? I think so. I think it was that. And then when I had it that short, I usually had it black or very, very dark. And that, so I knew that short hair looked good on me. But I also know that long hair looks good on me. So that was always the conundrum, you know? Something like that. They're kind of in werewolf mode, but that's okay. So, basically what I've always, looking back, what I've always wanted to do was to make people look at me. I did not want people to look at me. But if they looked at me, that I was kind of, I knew what they were looking at because I looked different from everyone else. I kind of hope that makes sense. It took me years to learn though, but back in the day, I was just trying. You know, sometimes you need to fake it until you make it. I'm squeezing a tiny bit, but not a lot. And so what happened then is I shaved part of my head. It was a very, very big step for me. I always, the style that I really, really liked is because my hair was so wonky, what I did a lot was I braided it. And yeah, that's usually what I did. My hair was also from all the styling and such that I did because it was so fine of texture. It kind of did not really like me. So yeah, I just tried to make something of that there. And to be, yeah, I was looking for my inner badass. That is basically the gist of it. And so yeah, I ended up shaving one side of my scalp and that was actually pretty cool. It was an experiment and usually my experiments are like, oh damn, that was not supposed to happen, but I kind of like it anyway, you know? So I had that for a little while and then basically I started my YouTube channel and something happened when I started my YouTube channel. What else do I want? Oh yes, let me go do my cream bronzer as well while I'm... But when I started my YouTube channel, something shifted. And yeah, people were looking at me online. You know, they were... And I was watching myself as well. Now, the first two videos... Oh, I was so... You know that when you are very, very drunk and you get into a taxi that you are trying to articulate every word exceptionally well because you don't want to let the taxi driver know that you're drunk? That's how I spoke English. When I look back, when I see those videos, I was trying so, so hard to be basically what I wasn't, but to be a personality on camera that people wanted to watch. Basically, I wanted to be... I tried to act like I thought people would want me to act. That's kind of the gist of it. I don't really know how to explain it in English right now because my brain is like, I don't know what you want to say. But I was being very, very serious. Yes, I am going to go to the blush. I'm very, very interested in this blush. I'm going to use the blush as I usually do. And that means I'm going to grab a brush because I always put my blush here and then pick up with a brush. I never do it on my face directly. I also understood that this is a pretty pigmented blush. So that is also because I don't know the formula. I'm going to do it on my hand first. Okay, so I've dotted it on my hand. Now I think I'm going to take this brush that I use for some of the lighter formulas, the wetter formulas. So yeah, basically something shifted and sometimes things happen at the right time, right? So I was watching, what was I doing? I think I was on Facebook and I saw a video of a girl about 20 years younger than me with the same type of bone structure in her face, same type of hair, and she just took the clippers and did that and it looked so, so cool. It looked so badass. And when I saw that, I was like, I want that. I want to feel how she is looking. But yeah, because I was still kind of, I like how this is looking. Because I was still kind of self-conscious, I was like, yeah, but I am 40 or something along those lines. 40. I was in my 40s. I'm 45 now. My YouTube channel is about 3 years old. So I think it's, what then? 3 years ago? So then I was kind of 40, 42-ish. Oh, it feels nice as well. I think I really like this. It's not really settling into lines either. It's creasing a tiny bit, but almost everything underneath my eye is creasing. And I can also maybe build up the concealer a hint in the inner corner. But yeah, basically when I saw her, I was like, oh, that's so cool. And then I was like, yeah, but I am in my 40s. Can I? And I know that a lot of you are screaming, yes, of course you can. And it's what I'm saying as well. But it needs to be in your mind too. Does that make any sense? So basically I can say, you know, and I get the comments sometimes, or actually more than sometimes, of people saying, I wish I could rock that. And I always say, you can, but you have to feel you can. You have to almost be ready for it. Does that make sense? Or at least that's how I felt. So I was like, I really want to do that. I want to feel the way that she is looking. And then find it was very, very radical as well, because it is a thing, right, to walk around like this, because people either think I'm sick, or they think I am, especially with the clothing style that I like, think that I am, I don't know, a Nazi or something like that, you know, white supremacist, which I'm not, but it is what people, how people can perceive me, especially combined with the tattoos that I have and the bomber style jackets and the army boots and all that. It is just, it can be a thing, you know, that I always keep forgetting. I thought about it for a few days, and if you do know me, you know that I can think about stuff for weeks before I do it, and usually it is an internal thing that is going on, and by the time I'm talking about it, I have usually already made my decision, but it has then been a few weeks. So for people who don't know how that is working for me, it is like I'm very, very impulsive. And I can be, but I'm actually not really. I was thinking about that for a few days, and then I was like, I'm going to talk about it. So I talked about it with my bestie, and she was like, I think that would look badass on you. I think that would be so amazing. And I'm like, yeah, but am I not too old for that? And she was almost like,
bitch, please.
you do what you want to. And no, I don't think that you are too old for that. I think you will look fabulous. So that was, yeah, kind of what I needed to hear. It was what I was saying to myself as well. But if someone else says it, who does not have any interest one way or another, and just wants you to be happy and be the best version of yourself, it is very, very powerful if someone says so. So, and if she were to have said, I don't think that you should, I don't think that I would have. Maybe I would. No, I don't. Maybe I would, but later. Then I got home and I talked to my family about it. Like, this is kind of what I want to do. What do you think about it? And they were all like, well, yeah. Yeah, you should. So, then I asked my husband to bring home the clippers, but he knows me, so he was like, sure, I will. Are you sure? And I said, I really do want to do this, but he also knows that it can take weeks for me to finally make up my mind. So he got the clippers, and it's one that you don't have to plug in, and he basically just did that. Now you have to. So that is the first time. And when he shaved my hair off, and if it wasn't him, it would have been my bestie. But if that hadn't happened, no, when he was shaving my hair, I was on the chair and I was having, I don't want to say I was having a panic attack. I wasn't, and I, on the one hand, I was very scared. On the other hand, it felt very, very liberating. And I was also like, if it's not what if I don't like the way that it's looking, I will just let it grow out. You know, my hair grows very, very quickly. I added freckles and a little bit of powder underneath my eyes, to kind of hopefully stop creasing. And it's not the product's fault. It's just that the way my eyes are. And I also put on my powder bronzer. And that's basically the only thing I did. And how do I put on my powder bronzer on top of something that isn't set? The same way I use my eyeshadow. I first tap it on. So basically set and then I blend. And it looks very, very pretty. Yes, eye primer. I have a new eye primer as well, but I know how the shadows perform of Lethal. I'm just going to try the new eye primer from Crow Pebble. And it is, oh, it looks very, very cool toned. Which I think that these shadows can handle, so that's... It's a little bit of a stiffer... a formula that... I don't really know how I feel about it just yet. I usually prefer something that is a little bit more liquidy. That needs to dry down a little. But it doesn't feel heavy. So that is good. Okay. So that is kind of the... Yeah, then when my hair was shaved, shoven. I think I'm just going to say shoven. I know it's not correct, but I like the word, Sumi. Anyway, when we did that, it did kind of freak me out when I looked in the mirror, not gonna lie. And I felt like I really needed makeup right then, because for me, especially then, it kind of needed to sink in a little bit. And I just wasn't confident enough to go outside just with my hair like that. And then just, you know, the way that I appeared on camera this morning, I just wasn't confident enough. And there's nothing wrong with that. You know, sometimes you just fake it until you make it. That's okay. And yeah, then I obviously got questions asking if I had been sick, which I hadn't. But yeah, how am I going to do this? I think green in the... Maybe I can kind of do something of a two-toned look again. It's going to be a long-ass video anyway. So yeah, you asked for this. It's not my fault. It's never my fault. So that was basically me shaving the first time. And then I obviously kept on shaving, right? Let's see. I'm going to start with the shade. I think I'm going to do a blue-green. And then maybe that reddish part on the bottom on both eyes. I think I'm going to do something along those lines. I'm going to start with a shade called Watery Grave. I do have to say that every time since that, it has made me more confident every time I shave my own hair. Because, I don't know, it almost feels like taking back your power. And... also, there are, where I live, there are small children, which isn't really that weird. But I've had it happen that especially girls just ask me, small girls, why I have no hair. And usually I just say, because I like it. And that's true. I've always had kind of a need to feel different. Because I've always felt different than everyone else. I don't know. Now it just feels so empowering. So basically, the first time that my hair was shaved, it was because I felt a need to be that badass, you know. And also, I wanted to do something different. And I wanted to be different. And I wanted to... really showcase that I was different from everyone else. That is kind of the gist of it, I think. But that was all underlying, you know. It was... I do feel, though, that it's a pretty radical statement, right? Something like this. If you want to do something radical for you, then make it radical for you. So, I don't know. Maybe you have always wanted to be a blonde and you've never had blonde hair. It could be very, very radical for you to go blonde then, you know, or vice versa. Or maybe you have very straight, or you have straight hair and you want curls, or vice versa. Or you have long hair and you want it short. You don't have to shave it right away. You can just go shorter. Does that make sense? And if you have very short hair, buy a wig. AliExpress has very fun wigs. I'm going to go to the shade Body Snatched next. And it's going to go on the other eye. I also feel that everyone should do what they feel comfortable with. It's absolutely not a bad idea to go outside of your comfort zone and to really trigger yourself, you know, by certain things. But you don't have to go as radical as this. That's it, right? If you don't feel comfortable in your own skin, that's what you project outside. Basically, if you feel comfortable in your own skin, if you feel pretty with the makeup that you're wearing, if you feel pretty in the dress that you're wearing or the pants or whatever, then that is what you project outside, you know? Okay, I'm going to go next to the shade Predator. Now, lethal shadows are like nomad shadows. At least that's where I compare them. They are very, very nice for quick and easy looks. That's how I use them. They will layer, but not indefinitely. So that is why I usually, when I work with Lethal Cosmetics or with Nomad Cosmetics, I kind of keep my looks simple. That does not mean that they have to look simple. Does that, yeah? So, yeah. And basically, you know, it is, now I'm putting blue eyeshadow on my eye. And this is a blue eyeshadow that I feel very, very comfortable in. I'm going to go outside in a two-toned look. And I know that there are not a lot of people who would do that. But I feel comfortable this way. And why do I feel comfortable this way? That is also it, you know. Because my hair is the way that it is, people are looking at me anyway. They are having an opinion on me anyway. So it doesn't matter. And it gave me such a confidence boost, honestly. Because I knew why people were looking. And yes, I know I look pretty. I know that. But I did not feel it then. You know, I just felt like the odd duck out. And people were looking at me and they were judging me. And I did not know why. And that made me even more self-conscious. Now that I know that they are looking at me because the first thing they see when they see me is this. That's the first thing they see. And then they see this. And then they see the rest of me. And sometimes it's the armor that I wear. When I'm feeling, I don't know, a little bit self-conscious that day, it's then the armor that I wear. And it's also, people have a reaction. It's just people have a reaction when they see me. And that is on them. It's not on me. But I kind of like, I don't know. I kind of like, it's not shocking value, but I kind of like giving them the, I don't know how to describe it in English. So yeah, I'm going to go to the shade Creature Feature. Let's see if I can deepen up the green enough. Oh, it pulls nice and green, so that's good. Maybe a little bit more on the aqua blue, but what I'm going to do in a minute is I'm going to put that green back on top again to make it a little bit more green. I like, because people have a certain standard, a certain image of how women should look or how a person should look, I like giving them another option. I'm going to go back with that green. Ooh, that's a very, very nice combination. So that they, I don't know, learn to appreciate something that is not, push them out of their comfort. I don't really know how to explain it, but basically, when someone looks at me and they have an opinion, and everyone has an opinion on everything, it's just human nature, and I don't mind that at all, but it is not on me, it is on them. So even people who love the way that I look, it's on them, it's not on me. Does that make any sense? So that's what I'm kind of learning now as well. I know that I cannot please everyone. So honestly, the only person I have to please is me. Yeah, that sounds kind of... Let's go to the shade The Final Girl and then Vengeful Spirit. So let's start with the final girl on a brush that is a little bit... I know the brush I want to use, but where did I put it? Here. So yeah, and basically now every time that I shave my hair, it's just taking back that power. You know, because I have the choice. It's my choice to shave my hair. No one else's. It's mine. And that feels very, very empowering. Now again, I'm not saying that you should. And if you are going to, do it because you want to. And not because someone else says you have to. Okay, I'm going to go to the shade Vengeful Spirit now. Not well like this, but that's okay. We're going to funk it up. Yes. Why? Because I can. I'm going to go to the shade Predator, which is that blue. No. I'm going to go to the shade Vengeful Spirit first. It's going to go in the outer corners of both eyes. And I'm also going to kind of blend it in the crease a bit. I don't know how it will show up with the blue, but we will see. Okay. I'm going to go to the blue again. I'm going to put that a little bit here. And I'm going to do the same with the teal on the other hand, other eye. I think that's a bit better. I'm actually using the shade Predator to deepen up here a little bit more. And then I will put that lighter green on top again, I think. I just want a little bit extra depth. First, I'm going to go straight to VH. I'm going to use all the shimmers. I'm going to start with the yellowy greeny one, which will probably be yellow on me because of the nature of my undertone. Ooh, that's pretty. Oh, so this is almost more of a topper shade. And am I correct in that? I think so. It's very pretty, very pretty. Yeah, I'm going to go to Spellbound next, which is that bluey shade. Or what is it? Purpley? Blue? I don't know. Periwinkle? I have no freaking idea. Cutesy. I am going to grab this shade straight to VHS, the first one that I used. I'm going to pull it a little bit. Oh, I love this combination so much. It turns purpley and greeny. I love this. I am going to blend the edges a little. Now I have that Ancient Evil shade left. That's for funsies. Put an orange eye pencil in the waterline and a little bit on my lashes. Then I'm going to put a little bit of glitter primer on top, not in my lash line, but on my bottom lid. And then I'm going to put the shade Ancient Evil on top of that. I like this. I'm going to finish everything off with liner lashes and a lippy, and then I will be back and I will give you my thoughts on everything that I used. Yes. The falsies I have on are my favorites from Primark, the Babydoll lashes in style 723. And I also put on the lip glossy balmy thingamajingy, but I also use a lip liner underneath. So I used, it's actually my favorite lip liner right now. It's the one from Catrice, a plumping lip liner in the shade Polite Rebellion, which is a warmer brown, a little bit more of an, oh, almost an orangey brownie thingamajingy. And it works very, very well with the gloss. And to honor Teresa, I put in my mermaid skeleton things and such. So yeah, I feel fabulous. Let me go over the stuff that I use really quickly. The primer, it feels nice. The foundation, I really like how the foundation is feeling. I did not powder it. And it is not settling into my smile lines here. The only place I powdered it was underneath my eyes, because it kind of helps my eyes not crease, and it worked. So now that it has settled, it just feels nice. It feels like my skin. It's maybe a hint too dark for right now, but because the formula is so thin, I feel I can get away with it. You still can see my skin through, so I actually don't know how they market it. Do they market this as a medium or as a full coverage? I don't know, but looking at it right now, it's a light to medium coverage, the way that I have used it. I think that I can build this up, I just didn't. And honestly, this shade to build up, it's just maybe one shade too dark for me to really, really build it up. But I feel like it looks very, very pretty. The concealer also felt really nice. It feels just right. Almost the sweet spot between the Fenty one that I have, which is more full coverage but sets on itself, and then more hydrating from Catrice. This feels very, very light. It does set on itself, and I can build it up without any issues. So I'm very happy about that. The blush, I don't necessarily want to say that it is a shimmer blush formula, but it is the most luminous cream blush formula that I have, and that was the reason that I wanted to try it. Now, when I look and I tilt my head a little, it just gives me a natural glow that I can also get when I use a liquid highlighter. I haven't. I don't know. I think it looks very pretty. And I really like the formula. Now, the way that I use it on my hand and then stipple it on with a brush, it works wonders. Now, you can see I'm pretty light. If you are darker, I think that if you're tan, you can still use this. But then just use it on your face and then blend it out on your face. If you're pasty pale, you can still use this, but use it as I did. Just one dot on the back of your hand. Pick it up with a brush. Swirl a little bit on your hand to get the excess off and then stipple it on your face. I am going to wear this all day. I don't know if I will probably forget, honestly, to give you a wear time test, but I will keep on testing this out. Let me know if you want to have a dedicated review on it, because if you want to, then I can. And if there's not really any response on that, I will just give you my final thoughts in my July ranking video. The lip balm has a slight minty in it. Now, they have multiple colors. I like it. I like that I have a mini. I like that I can kind of try it out. I really like formulas like this. But I also have formulas like this. This is a little bit more opaque. I feel like my favorite that I have from Lethal in the shade Nova. But it is very comfortable. Yeah, and I think that is basically her brand, right? A little bit more natural looking. I really like how I'm looking right now. Yes, I feel very, very pretty. And then the eyeshadow palette, yeah. I also have the liners on the way, but I ordered them separately so I would get the palette before I got the liner. So I am actually expecting the liners very, very soon. First off, I love Lethal's formula. Lethal's formula is, in my opinion, very similar to Nomad's formula in that this is a very blendable formula and not particularly a buildable formula. So I layered on this eye, I layered, I think, three... or maybe four shades, and you can easily blend them into each other, but it is not that they really, really build on top of each other. That you, for instance, if I were to put the green teal here, it would blend into the darker blue and not make the darker blue more teal. Yes? I hope that kind of makes sense. That's just the way that their formula is. So for me, Lethal's formula, as is Nomad's formula, are for quick and easy, but very, very pretty looks. Now, this looks like I did a lot of effort and I didn't. And that's the makeup that I love. You know, I love this and I love Lethal as a brand. I love their whole aesthetic. I love their formula. I love Teresa. I've been watching her for a few years now. I am proud to call myself a garbage person and a pumpkin baby. Yes. Girl, you killed it. Honestly, you killed it. And I cannot wait to receive the liners as well. And then I will play with those too. That is it for today's video. I hope that I answered the question about why I shaved my hair in the beginning and why I keep shaving my hair. Because basically, it's a choice, right? That I keep shaving my hair. The choice every single time is I take back the power that is mine. Because it's my choice to shave my hair and no one else's, and it's just, it feels very, very empowering for me, and just, it feels good, you know, it's me. So yeah, that is it for today. Let me know what you thought of the video. Let me know if you have any of the products. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Oh yeah, and obviously I will leave Teresa's channel down below. You need to check her out. If you don't know Teresa, who are you, honestly? Go watch her, say hi, tell her I sent you, and give her a lot of love because she deserves it, as we all do, right? Yes, I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very, very soon, yeah, tomorrow in my next one. Bye, guys.